Hey everybody, and welcome to this week's Design Cinema. This is Feng Zhu speaking, and this is episode 53, Illustration and Industrial Design. So I'm going to continue the same type of lesson that we started in episode 52, in which we focus on more of the core fundamentals and the kind of the philosophy behind this industry. And this episode is aimed more for students who are interested in the difference between the two industries, the illustration industry and the industrial design industry. Because from an outsider point of view, these two industries appears to be very similar. Illustration and industrial design both use drawings to communicate an idea. However, from a core perspective, the two sides are actually very, very different from each other. The career path could be very, very different from each other. But before we start this episode, I do want to make it very clear that I'm approaching this topic from a broad perspective. There are many, many crossovers between the two majors. There are illustrators who go into industrial design, and there are industrial designers who do illustration. So this is not meant to be an absolute, right, like black or white kind of episode. There's a lot of gray in between. And I'll mention those differences as we go through the episode. So I'm going to break this down to about three parts. We're going to start with the differences in terms of pipeline. We'll talk about differences in terms of education. And finally, the differences were kind of the different career path, the jobs you can have when you major in one of these industries, right? So let's start with the pipeline. So actually, let me just slow down here a second. I myself study industrial design. I went to the Art Center College of Design in Pasadena, in Los Angeles, and I was majored in industrial design, but I did take some subclasses in illustration, which I'll mention once we touch the education side. Okay, so let's talk about the core difference in terms of production pipeline. And I'm going to load up a couple of illustrations. Let's start with the illustration side. And here are some pictures. So here are some of my favorite illustrators, some very, very well-known famous ones. Here's the Mona Lisa by Leonardo da Vinci. Here's Mucha, who does these beautiful Art Deco type illustrations. Norman Rockwell, a very, very classic American painter. He's like an American icon. His paintings are just absolutely gorgeous. Here's Alan Lee, illustrated a lot of the Lord of the Rings, who also then worked on the Lord of the Rings films. And of course, Frank Frazetta, an extremely famous illustrator. So what are we looking at here? You know, what makes this different from industrial design? Well, the main difference is that, let me put the pipeline, okay, is that illustration is produced directly for the consumer. The consumer could see this illustration. That is exactly what the eyeball is seeing. And also, the money is attached directly to this illustration. So let's go down to the pipeline. So again, I want to stress this is a broad perspective, a broad scope point of view of this industry. This is not a per individual view, right? I'm trying to simplify this as much as I can so it's easier to understand for the students out there, okay? So let's talk about the core pipeline for Illustrator and its end product. So to start these, funding-wise, you actually don't really need any funding. The only thing you need are the materials, maybe the oil, the canvas, and the artist. That's pretty much all you need to produce these paintings. There's no funding necessary. So you have the artist, that's the pipeline. The artist produces the artwork, and the artwork goes to the consumer. And this consumer doesn't have to be you and I. This consumer could be the clients. It could be an advertising agency. It could be a book cover where the author themselves commissioned the illustrators for a certain cover. But the end result is that the artwork is the money. The consumer eyeballs, let me just write that here, right? Consumer eye, okay, equals the artwork. Okay, well, I should write that the other way around, shouldn't I? I should write artwork here, right? One, artwork is the money. Two, equals direct consumer. So that means whoever is buying the book cover or whoever is buying this painting, their eye is looking at this. This is the end result. This Norman Rockwell painting is the result. And two, the Norman Rockwell also has value attached to it. So if I was to go and steal this Norman Rockwell or go and destroy it and burn it up in a fire, that would be a tremendous loss for the collector, for the original owner of this painting, because the value here is forever lost. So that is one of the easiest ways to track the core difference between illustration and industrial design is the product right here. Okay, one, the money is tied together with the illustration, and two, the consumer is looking at the illustration directly, right? We see the Mona Lisa, we see the Mucha, we see Norman Rockwell, we see the Alan Lee, we see Frank Frazetta. So this is how the artwork is produced. This is the final product. So I write here. The final product is the illustration themselves. Now, I put Alan Lee and Frank Frazetta Frazetta here, because these guys do cross over. This is illustrations done for the book Fellowship of the Ring, the illustrated books by Alan Lee. And of course, these books eventually made themselves into films by Peter Jackson, right? And these designs, many designs done for it, have been carried into the films. So this is when crossover happens. And Alan Lee himself worked on the designs of the film, right? So again, it's not absolute, right? And Frank Frazetta, same thing. This is done for, I believe, the cover to Princess of Mars, which recently in Hollywood, the movie John Carter just got released based on the exact same IP, same author, right? So these are crossover products. But when these were done, they were meant to be illustrations. These are not meant to carry a design into a film or a game. They're purely meant to sell the product, sell the artwork themselves, right? So now let's go to the industrial design side of things. Boop. Okay, let's load that up. And let me load a couple of industrial design products. So notice I didn't put any paintings or drawings here. What I've put here are the products themselves. Let me write that here. Okay. So for us, industrial design, our main focus is not the artwork, but the products here, the end result. So we don't have this here, this artwork to consumer. This is not here. The consumer never gets to see the artwork behind Assassin's Creed, behind Transformers, right? They have to dig pretty hard to look for them up. They have to go behind the scenes books or art of books. But your average consumer, the average moviegoer with the video game players, they're not, they could care less what the artwork looks like. So that's the kind of fundamental core difference when you compare the products. So let's load its pipeline up. Okay, so in a pipeline of industrial design, and you know, before I continue, I also want to stress that I'm focusing this episode primarily for the entertainment design industry. I'm not talking about the car industry or product industry. It's more for it's what we do. Okay, so the pipeline for industrial design here for film or video game goes like this. It breaks down to these three major parts. Okay, you got pre-production, production, and post-production. For us in the design side, we are here at the tip of pre-production. Here's design. Okay, and you can see how long this pipeline is. For a typical film or video game, this is generally somewhere between 2 to 3 years, sometimes even longer than that. Some video games could take 5 years to make, right? So we exist here, and the typical time period to produce design is from somewhere between 2 to maybe 6 months. This is very typical average time it takes to design everything. So during this phase, that's when industrial designers are hired to do the characters, the environments, the sets, and whatnot. And that all exists in the pre-production phase. Okay. So once we're done here, that's going to move into production. And here you got the 3D guys, you got the texture guys, the sound guys, all those guys come in. And in post-production, you got your VFX, compositing, all those kind of work comes into post-production. And marketing comes in here. So all these people come together to make the final product. And that product is what equals to the money. That's what the consumer is actually seeing and touching and interacting with, not your concept art from over here. So if you go back to the illustration here, notice that the artist, one person, produces generally one artwork. That one artwork is then sold to the consumer or the clients, and that is what the consumer sees. You know, starting from over here, that is the final product. Versus in here, the final product and our art are never touched. The consumer does not view what we have drawn. So the fundamental difference, the thinking behind it becomes quite different. Versus illustration, you have to make sure that this, you know, stands out. In design, this stands out, the product, not the art, right? So another clear example would be, say, the iPad. Somebody at Apple designed the iPad on a piece of paper, and that went into production. However, when the iPad gets produced, the consumer only care about that product. They go to the store and buy it. At that point, you can essentially destroy the drawing of the iPad, and nobody will care. In fact, the sales of the iPad will not be affected whatsoever. You cannot do that with original artwork. You destroy it, there goes the original artwork and all its value. Okay, so this sort of summarizes the pipeline between the two. Okay, so let's move forward now to the difference in education. Okay, so there are a lot of schools out there who teach illustration and a lot of schools that teach industrial design. So depending on the kind of line of work you want to focus on, you want to pick one that caters it to you. So this is, again, a generalization. There are schools that does both. There are schools that does some better. There's some schools that sometimes some worse. And there are positives and negatives for both majors. So you really have to focus on the field that you want to go into. Okay, but let's start with the illustration first. So let me load up a couple of lessons that are generally taught when you attend the illustration school. And those are things like landscape painting, master copies, sculpting, a lot of life drawing, still lifes, portrait drawings. These tend to be the main focus point. And the core studies takes place here. So personal expression and individualism and personal style is very, very important to an illustrator because remember, you're selling a painting. That painting is you. Your blood and tears and your sweat is wrapped up in these paintings. And when the consumer or the client is buying your work, they're essentially buying a little bit of you in it, right? This painting here, this sculptor has the creator inside it, right? So these are worth value simply because of who created it. So therefore, personality and personal style becomes very, very important in the educational side of illustrators, right? They want to break out. They want to create their own Frank Frazetta style. They want to, they want to create something like so they make their own name and not be a copy of Frank Frazetta, right? They want to be yourself. You want to create that. And to do that, you need a personal style. You want to tell a certain story. You want to focus on a theme. Maybe you want to paint stuff that shows society in a certain way, or maybe you're trying to evoke emotion in somebody. That stuff is very important during the educational side. There's also a heavy focus on technical skills. Okay, and for illustrators in general, there's a heavy focus on anatomy and figure drawing. So if you look up here, you see the portraits, life drawing, the master copy, the sculpting here. All these have characters in them, right? Heavy character-driven studies. And then different mediums. This goes along with the personal style, right? Maybe you like to work with charcoal. Maybe you could work with oil, maybe gouache, maybe watercolor. There's just thousands of unlimited ways to express your artwork, right? You can even use metal. You could put materials directly in your painting. It's up to you. That's what makes an illustration worth its value or have a certain style to it. And that's what the consumer or the collector is looking for, right? So even The New Yorker, a magazine, they're hiring you because they like the way you draw a certain thing, right? Maybe you draw characters and the characters look quite different than the guy, next door. So the magazine hires you to do it. So personal expression, different medium, experimenting with different styles is quite important during the educational phase of an illustrator. And also, a lot of self-promotion. You have to learn how to promote yourself through galleries, meet the right people, get your stuff seen in front of the public, because you are producing artwork and that artwork is your income. So you got to put a lot of time and invest that lot of energy into self-promotion. Okay, so this is the kind of stuff that a lot of illustration schools tend to focus their students on. So now let's go to industrial design. Okay, so this is the major I chose when I went to art center. And this is also the same major that we teach here at my school here. Okay, so let me load up some pictures. So what I have here is also artwork, but you can see that it's quite different, right? This is done by Ralph McCurry, who recently passed away. And Ralph McCurry was a major, major influence for us in the design side. He was one of the original designers on Star Wars, which of course is the most iconic film of all time. And you got Sid Mead, another major influence for us. And over here, we got some rapid prototyping machines and some 3D modeling. So what's the core difference between this painting, or these two paintings here, and the paintings over here? Well, this is the end product. This is not. Right, these paintings are meant to show to producers, executives, guys with money, so they can see, oh, what does this movie look like when it's done? Because these are, remember, done during pre-production. This is before the film is even made, before sometimes the script is even written. So that way, Ralph McCurry does these kind of imaginations, uses his imagination to come up with these scenes that help illustrate what the final product may look like when the consumer sees it. But the consumer themselves will never see that. Just like the same with Sid Mead's cars or his spaceship designs. These things are not meant for consumer, they're meant for the pipeline. They're meant for the people who's going to take over, take a look, what does it look like, gives you the visual language and communication as far as the product goes. And in industrial design, you also tend to learn things like CNC machines, rapid prototyping, so you can make your designs into little mock-ups, little models, easier for the next guy to see. Right? You also, there's a lot of 3D modeling. So let me put the core techniques. So unlike illustration, in which personal style and personal expression is quite important. In industrial design, those are less important to us because we don't care about do you have to draw very, very different from the guy next to you. In fact, most designers draw very similar. You look at Sid Mead, Doug Chang, Joe Johnston, many of my friends, myself included, our marker sketches look almost identical. We use the same pen, we use the same brand of markers. We don't try to make our styles different from one another because that's not what the clients are paying us for. The clients are paying for the actual content. What is happening in the painting? What's the design of the painting? What's the design of this car? those are things that break industrial designers apart from one another, not the individual styles or the mediums. So in fact, most schools in industrial design teach a very common technique that are used by the industry. So while students are in school, many of them actually look exactly the same. So even for our school, when I'm critiquing some students' work, sometimes I can't tell which student did which work, but I could tell them apart based on their design language. That is very, very different. So also, there's a heavy emphasis on problem solving. For example, how does a car work if it's powered by maybe a steam engine? Or how does a car work if it's powered by batteries? You know, is that going to change the design? Is that going to change the look? So there's a lot of functionality to do with design. Main focus on that. That's what the clients want. In illustration, there's actually a heavy focus on the 2D side thinking. How do you make your drawings look good? How do you make light look really good when it's fractioning through glass? How do you make cloth look good? So it's quite a little difference in terms of the main core focus. We also focus on fundamentals, right? But our fundamentals are generally focused more based on science. So we explain things more from like perspective, the light particle, wavelength, and how does light affect materials when the blue light hits black metal? What happens to it? These things are generally less, a little bit less on the illustration side. So illustration, of course, also has science. It can go hardcore into anatomy, the muscles, and what happens when you clap your hand. Quite important. But you'll see later that illustration are generally soft surface, soft focus, like anatomy and creatures. And industrial design are focused more on materials, like metal, plastic, glass, these type of things. Whereas illustration is skin, is texture, is cloth, right? Soft stuff. So also there's quite a bit of lesson on pipeline. You have to know that you are not the one individual. In illustration, you are one, right? In the pipeline, you are one of, say, 1,000. So you have to understand how to work with a massive group of people to make sure that your design, once it's finished, can move down the pipeline and help these 999 people make it into a final product. Okay. So, and then lastly, this mass consumer focus thing is very important. Okay. For my line of work, you know, and also up here, you see Star Wars, Mass Effect, and cars. These are products aimed at a very, very big market, millions and millions of people. And that's what these clients want to do. They want to sell this product to as many people as they possibly can. So as a designer, you have to understand how to design for mass market approach. From illustration side, that's not always the case. You don't need to necessarily design for a million people. In fact, you could focus on 10,000 people. But if those 10,000 people are paying $1 million for one of your paintings, hey, that's good, right? And of course, people, illustrators like Leonardo da Vinci and these guys are catering to millions of people out there. But when they start their paintings, they might not necessarily want to target a mass audience. They just target themselves. You know, it's like, hey, I want to paint movie stars using charcoal and watercolor. I'm going to mix these two. That's my style. That's what I want to do, and build my fan base around my artwork. Versus for us on the industrial design side, we build our designs for mass market from day one. There's no like, oh, I'm going to paint a charcoal character and make them all crazy and no one's going to understand it, but it's so different from the rest of the world. But we can't do that. We have to make sure that it's always catered to mass market from day one. So these are the two core differences in the education system between the two majors. Now, from a school standard point of view, there are a lot more illustration schools out there than industrial design schools. And for industrial design schools that teach entertainment, there's even lesser than that. Okay, so let me write entertainment. So there are probably thousands and thousands and thousands of illustration schools out there. In fact, even my school, we're surrounded by about maybe five or six art schools, illustration schools. But as far as industrial design with a focus on entertainment, you probably only have a handful around the entire planet that teach this kind of stuff. So a lot harder to find this kind of education, a little bit more common. But because there's more of these schools, if you do want to focus on illustration, you got to pick a good one. Because when there's massive amounts of something, there's bound to be a good and there's bound to be bad. So you got to be very careful. So anyways, let's move on to lastly, to career path. Okay, and then later I'll summarize all these things together. So, boom, let's talk about career. Okay, and we'll start with illustration again, the typical career path. So, like I mentioned earlier, there's a lot of crossovers between illustrators and industrial designers. Illustrators could go here, and industrial designer could go here. But if you do focus your major on illustration, or later focus on industrial design, let me put that over here. Okay, those majors tend to drive you down a certain career path, and either both paths are good. It's up to you as an individual which one you prefer to do. So let's load some pictures here. So I got Frank Frazetta again. And over here, there's Norman Rockwell in the middle there. And this is Glenn from Disney, a very famous key animator that have worked on many of the Disney's famous animations. So let's talk about the illustration side. So like I said earlier, illustration are generally categorized into soft surface, meaning that most of the stuff they do are like creatures and characters, or landscapes, you know, things like that are very soft to the touch. You can almost imagine it. They're not man-made. They're created naturally, right? Where they flow very softly. So that's the core focus. You can in fact see it in these examples. You can see Frank Frazetta, there's characters here. Norman Rockwell's got characters everywhere, right? Just one little environment here. And of course, Disney guy here has characters on his screen. So a lot of character-focused majors or job scopes. Okay. Now, as far as what you could do as a job scope, well, I think for most illustrators, they want to be over here, right? They want to be a recognized illustrators. It doesn't have to necessarily mean famous, but the only way you make money is by selling your artwork. So therefore, you have to be recognized because people are going to Frank Frazetta because it's Frank Frazetta. People are going to Norman Rockwell because it's Norman Rockwell. Their names are just as important as the work they do, right? Fundamentally very different from industrial design. Directors could hire us, they could care less who I am. You know what I'm saying? They could hire me based on my portfolio only. My name has nothing to do with it. But for illustrators, sometimes the name is quite important. They're part of the marketing. You could say that, hey, this poster is done by Frank Frazetta. Well, that's worth a lot more money than if the poster is done by a no-name illustrator, right? Very, very different. So for illustrators, you've got to make your name for yourself. Your artwork has to make a name for itself because that's what the consumer are paying for, you. Okay, so that means you can have galleries, you can have art books, all these things are there to try to promote your artwork. So, of course, you can also go in a career in which you're illustrating for books, movies, films, posters, covers. These are a very common job scope for illustrators out there, like painting the cover for Time Magazine or National Geographic, The New Yorker. A lot of good illustrators do those. A lot of famous book covers are done by illustrators. So, good career path, and it's a major job scope for most of my friends who are from illustration. You can also go into marketing art, which is similar to, you know, essentially a movie poster is marketing. So marketing art is also quite common. To give you an example of how the difference between illustration and industrial design, you know, you take a film like Transformers. Well, the original design were done by industrial designers, a bunch of my friends. We all, every single one of us came from industrial design, and we worked on the robot designs and the sets and whatnot. But when Hasbro came in, Hasbro wanted to market these designs to the general public in terms of toys. Well, at that point, they'll bring in an illustrator who will take our designs and change them into these cool posters. Because our designs from the art department, remember, we're in pre-production here, right? And then the marketing's over in post-production, right? Much later. So our drawings look kind of like these turnaround drawings, side view, front view, kind of three-quarter perspective, kind of boring because we're drawing these for pipeline. Remember, we're drawing this for the 999 people down the pipeline. They have to understand our drawing. For marketing, this thing is not going to market well to some kid. Okay, so for marketing, they're going to take the same designs that we provide to the, whoops, to the art department, and they're going to turn into these cool poses and action explosions and stuff. And those are meant for movie posters, meant for the cover, for the toy box and whatnot. So two different career paths kind of meet with a similar department, right? Marketing art. So you can also be a key animator like Glenn over here, right? Who sets the tone and the keys for all these major Disney films. Great job to have. I'm sure he also could play the role of creative art director. This is you basically telling other art directors and artists how to create and design the color palettes for a particular product. A lot of illustrators also end up in layout and color keys and mood, and especially in studios such as Disney, DreamWorks, and Pixar, employ a lot of illustrators to do these jobs. And you've probably seen these in art of books in which they try to define the tone, the color, and the mood of these movies. And that takes a very good understanding of lighting, of emotions, expression, in which the illustrators tend to focus heavily on during their educational phase. Okay, and costume and character design, right? Remember I mentioned soft surface. So again, this is not a specific case. I'm talking about from my personal observation. Most of my friends who majored in illustration from our center tend to go out and focus on character and costume design. They still work on films and games, but they work from the character side of things. Versus for us, we kind of do everything on the projects, environments, vehicles, sets, even graphic design. But for us, we focus less on characters, but more on the hard surface, which I'll mention right now. Okay, so let's go to the industrial design side. So here we have three very famous designers. Here's Ralph McCurry, right, the guy we mentioned earlier who just recently passed away. Here's Sid Mead, a very iconic figure in design. And here's Joe Johnston, who designed the original X-Wing and whatchamacallit, TIE Fighter for the original Star Wars, who is now a very well-known director. His last film was the Captain America. Right? So I also like all these three guys influenced my personal career heavily when I was going through school. So what are some of the jobs that for industrial designers, right? So industrial designer for entertainment. Remember, I'm talking about our industry here, not manufacturing and cars and stuff. So anyways, so for us, we're categorized mostly under hard surface. So that means environments, props, sets, vehicles, right? And occasionally we do character design as well, but that's definitely not the core focus for us. We're definitely focused on more of the man-made stuff, or even planets, things that are, you know, more little hard, like rocks and stones, caves, and these kind of things. These kind of environments are generally what we focus on. Cityscapes, landscapes, right? So, and for us, most of our jobs consist in video games, the effects studios, and the film industry. So most of my buddies that I work with on these products are, I say overall, about 80 to 90% industrial design background during their educational phase, right? So once in a while, I do bump into some illustrators here and there, but most of them are, again, focused on the character side. They come in from the costume department or the creature department, a slightly different department than the hard surface guys, especially on films. They divide them into two different departments. So they're in the soft surface, we are in the hard surface. We can also go into product design. Many of us do real-world products, such as toys and theme parks. They also take an industrial design background to work on them, right? Because you got to understand some structural things, some materials, that kind of focus. Okay, so production designer, this is similar to a creative art director. Production designer is kind of the boss guy, right? The guy who's in charge of other designers. This is the title given mostly on films, so that's another career path. You could be in the concept department. This is part of the dream job for many of us in the design side because this is the most fun job. Concept departments are generally hired to blue sky projects. So before a film or a game is made, you got about three, maybe four guys who work for a few months just blue skying anything they could think of and put on paper, put these sketches on paper to show the producers and directors what the product could look like. So it's a very fun job. And you could have crossovers. You could go into the real world. I have many friends, myself included, who has done architecture. Some of my friends have done military designs, you know, real military designs, interior designs for bars, for clubs, right? Because it's very similar. The design thinking behind it is still very structural, that once you could do industrial design, you could carry your designs into the real world. So the focus on these two, primarily, if you look at it, is that these guys' jobs, their final product is to consumer. For us, the final product is not in front of the consumer. So I think that's the fundamental difference here. So for us, we kind of have to learn to work in a team, have to work on a, you know, big giant pipeline, have to think mass market. For illustrator, it's more about the craft, their individualism, their own work. Okay, and the focus is quite different. Illustrators mostly soft surface, understand skin, understand anatomy, understand cloth, understand these kind of soft things, beautiful colors, moods, color charts. For industrial designers, more about understanding of surface, such as glass, metal, plastic, learn to use good perspective, lighting in terms of science, cameras, focal lens, these type of things, a little bit more scientific driven type of things, you know? So very different. So for you guys out there who are students and you want to choose an education, at the end of the day, it's up to which kind of thing interests you, right? Don't choose it simply because, you know, you're forcing it. If you like to do, you know, my general advice to students is if you want to get out there and do marketing art, especially, you know, posters for movies, book covers, and do some character designs here and there, illustration is probably a safer bet to go on. If you're more interested in doing spaceships, science fiction stuff, like games like Mass Effect and vehicle designs and making things work, little parts and mechanical joints, then industrial design most likely is the major you should choose. So we could do both, right? I have many students in our school who started in illustration in a previous school, graduated from those schools, and they are now at my school studying industrial design, and that gives you kind of the best of both worlds. So it's all at the end of the day up to you as an individual. So I hope this kind of clarifies a little bit of these two very different majors. that's out there. Both of them are very, very good. You know, there's positive and negative to both sides. So for me, I know I love my job. I like what I do. I like the project I worked on, but sometimes I also envy what the illustrators get to do because they get to paint some really cool stuff that I have a very rare chance of doing. Things like book covers and these, you know, movie posters and book covers. The clients generally don't hire us to do those kind of stuff. So, and there's illustrators, friends of mine, who wishes to work on video games, to design the spaceship and stuff, and they don't get to work on that. So clients pick you generally based on your background, which one is your major focus. So again, choose carefully. You know, by the end of the day, have fun with it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and I will see you guys next time. All right, bye bye.